lost all but one, but I feel like this guy has a lot of potential. He's looking better every time I see him.
Yeah. We saw him, like, the first game we saw him, he came out, and he was just, like, nervous, but more so, like, just really focused, really concentrated, slowly got closer and closer to his monitor.
Yeah. He's a really, really solid up-and-comer. I wouldn't say he's a solid player, like, yet, but he's an up-and-comer.
It's someone to watch. You know, maybe fourth round of Pro League, he makes, like, a big move, takes out some big names. I could see it. Maybe he needs some more time.
Yeah, just keep an eye on him is what I'd recommend.
Keep him in your mind, in the back of your mind.
Trap is somebody who needs very little introduction. He's played so many Pro League matches. Was very solid when he was playing on STX. And, of course, later on in Seoul in the GSTL. And now moved to Incredible Miracle. So he's had a kind of a rocky ride. But he's still managed to keep himself in tip-top shape. And that says a lot. That resilience is really important. Polar Knight, our two-player map, could be our final map of this matchup between these two. Let's find out who's going to take it here at the SPL.
Up here in the north, for Prime, the Zerg player, it's Cassia.
Cassia, just very, very fast, very map aware, against his opponent for IM, former STX player / Soul player, it's Trap.
Yeah, both these players wearing glasses.
Yep. This is true. Did you read Where's Waldo, or rather play,
yeah,
I guess?
Yeah.
I loved that book series when I was a kid. That along with I Spy.
I was the same, actually. I loved both of those books. I used to, like, do a page and then, like, you know, a month later when I forget where stuff is, like, do it again. And, like, do it again.
Yeah. My parents and you know, my teacher always encouraged me to read. And they would always tell me, you know, they'd be like, I always finished my work really quickly. Cause I was a pretty bright young individual. Like, I would finish my math homework very quickly. I was very good at spelling. So, like, anything that happened to do with spelling when I was in, like, second grade, I would do so quickly. He'd always be like, all right, go to the library. Like, go get Nintendo Power from the library. Cause my library had, like, video game magazines. And then I went back and she'd be like, no, get a real book. I want you to get a hardcover book. So I go back to the library. And I come back with an I Spy book and she was like, listen. But actually, I became a pretty big reader in school after that, after I got past my I Spy phase. Read the Redwall books. Did you read those? Book about, like, animals and
no,
they fight
no,
and stuff,
no.
Like mice, mostly mice, Martin the Warrior.
I didn't read that one, though. My brother read all of those.
Those were a great book series for me when I was in elementary school, man. I love that. Looks like we're going to have double hatch before pool. Cassia's, like, pulling no punches with his economy. He's going to take those murals. He's going to take what he wants.
Yeah. If you want something, you got to take it with confidence.
Yes. Always, always remember this.
Girls like it.
Yeah.
It's a good thing to do, just in general. Get what you want. Don't
minerals,
be a meanie, though.
Minerals don't like it, though. They're like, oh, no, I want to stick around a little longer.
No, they're going to be mined.
Also, cannons don't like it. The cannon behind that third base, things can be a little bit rough.
No.
He sees it, but as he's taken a gateway expand approach to this, there's not much he can do to punish. Goes stalker first.
Has it rallied all the way over at that third base? Yeah, see?
Yeah.
Right next to it.
In fact, I think he actually did make a zealot before that stalker. So. Stalker before sentry.
Yeah, that zealot's moving across the map. I can see it on the mini-map.
He's also...
There it is.
Yep, there he is. He's also delaying his mothership core slightly by this. And further his Nexus a little bit. But what he wants to accomplish with this is forcing more Zerglings and possibly killing a queen that spawns. Very rarely see Zerg players actually lose their queen to this because it's just, I mean, once you have that spawning pull up, you get a few units out you can defend. But, you know, he could actually kill the queen here. I don't even think he's going to make a queen until he deals with those units because this is a the fastest possible pressure you could really put on against the greediest build, the latest spawning pool. So you might have some trouble here. I don't think the hatch is going to go down, but he's forced a lot of Zerglings here.
He's getting some damage on it. It's about half. 8 Zerglings so far being made. And it looks like he's just going to back off, actually.
Yeah, he's like, I'm cool with that.
He sends the Zealot forward. Looks like on the minimap. Oh, Zealot comes back.
Indecisive Zealot. Make up your mind. Remember Brent was talking about confidence? This is not it, Zealot. You need to pick
something
and stick with it.
Yeah. And Stargate goes down, as well as 2 gateways. Could put on a little bit of pressure. You know, he did a lot of damage to that hatchery.
I feel like Cassia has this insane mini-map checking ability. Like, he is always on top of you. You can just see it.
He actually moves his head.
Yeah.
He's not a guy that uses his eyes. He uses his head.
Yeah. Use your head, man. Famous words.
Be smart.
Well, he's going to have a bit of trouble getting anything done with those Zerglings, which is pretty annoying for him. Oracle comes out here. And immediately Spore Crawlers are going up back at home. Actually, that's a Spine Crawler. He may be expecting 4 gateway pressure. He's like playing super safe.
Yeah.
Or it was a mistake and he meant to make Spore Crawlers.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, Cassia is very meticulous in his gameplay. You know, he's a guy that will have, you know, his Zergling burrowed at your third or fourth base to just delay it just that little bit.
When I see him play, I actually think of a player from a completely different genre of games. I see Mewtwo King from Smash Brothers and him. Like, he's like seeing things in the game that we don't see. All right, here we go. The units are actually surrounded here by the Zerglings, but there's so many Zealots and the Mothership corrupting out as well. It's not going to be cost efficient to trade that, and here comes that Oracle.
No, losing a bunch of Zerglings there is not what he wants to do. Those Zealots only losing a bit of health, and they're going to come across this Oracle in the main base doing some damage. It has 2 kills so far. He's going to be pushed away. Zergling's trying to come to the front. Trap's base not going to be able to get past that Stalker. And there's a lot of Zealots here.
Yeah. And he's got basically, I mean, there's a lot of damage output in this Cross Army. He could just try to kill the hatchery, but he wants to trade efficiently, and this Oracle helps out so much with that. Really nice timing attack here by Trap. And with all the damage he did earlier, this hatchery is almost certain to fall. I mean, there's just not enough units here to defend. I don't even know if that recall was, like, necessary. I mean, if he didn't recall, he would have at least got a really good trade against the Zerglings, which is already good that the Zerglings were made, because he now has only 39 drones against 43 probes.
Yeah. I mean, very interesting there. He did a lot of damage, forced a ton of Zerglings, which are now going to come across the map and do absolutely nothing.
Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's now a horrible position for Cassia. He has to make something happen here, and a bit overzealous Trap moved out, but even still, he's not going to be able to get a lot of damage down here. He's going to get a probe, and I guess he got that one Zealot. So, this is not a good position for Cassia. He's way overmade Zerglings. In panic, and a reasonable panic, because we saw that the hatchery could have possibly gone down there if he didn't make all those Zerglings. The 24 extra he made after that, though, was not so sure about that.
I'm not so sure about it either. We see Blink being chrono-boosted right now. There's no probes going down, plus one to attack being chrono-boosted as well. Looks like he wants to go for a bit of a timing attack here. Cassia is keeping his Zerglings over here, and it looks like he might... Well, he has restarted probe production, so he might just go for third base here.
There's no word yet or name for this build that we've been seeing a lot in Code S, where a Pro-Oss player will do a +2 Stalker Blink timing attack off 3 Nexi, but 2 mining bases, where they don't use a third base. They wall it off. It's very tricky. It's hard for a Zerg to really identify exactly what type of push is coming his way. And with this cannon going down here, I think that's actually what we're going to see. I think he's just going to... He's going to make the Nexus, set up the infrastructure, the gateways next to it, not mine from it, and just hit +2 Blink Stalker timing. But he is missing one crucial component, which is the +2. He's not actually started that. I don't know if he knows, because he needs that if he wants to actually commit to this attack properly.
Yeah, he definitely wants it. Our Observer was actually highlighting the fact that Cassio is making 7 Overlords at the same time. His supply blocked at, I think, 93. But did get that up. He's making a ton of roaches. He has +1 as well as plus to speed, I guess you can say. Speed upgrade for roaches coming out around as well.
He has a lot of army supply. I mean, he has double his opponent's army supply. But the composition that he has is, half of it is going to be useless against force fields if the force fields are good. Good reveal here on those cloaked tumors. And he's got a great position here with his roaches, setting up a nice flank here. Just so many force fields. He has to be very careful. Any time he can buy just by walking back and forth is going to be excellent for him. There's a very plus two, a very late plus two started now.
That is a very plus two indeed.
It's very, very late on that. Very plus two though still. Wow.
Such damage.
Such forge. I feel like, I think he's just like, this timing doesn't really work out as well as I would have thought when he has this many Zerglings. And, you know, he didn't hit the plus two with it. So he's just continuing to produce probes. He's up to 67 here. And this counterattack, unfortunately for Cassia, is just not likely to get a lot of damage done.
Yeah.
Ooh, gotta be careful with those.
He has got the infestation pit down. But so far, he hasn't really done anything with it. He has a Spire coming up as well, trying to take a fourth base.
You think he's going to switch to Mutas? I think he could, but he doesn't have a lot. He doesn't have enough gas to do a big switch. And it would be okay for him if he's able to get a lot of Mutas out, because it's double Colossus out of two Robos what he's facing. That was a bit of a wasted Zergling attack there.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, this is a Sentry and a Warp Prism, the most dangerous thing you could ever see in StarCraft. It's like more dangerous than a Battlecruiser. Here we go.
He has some units in the main, very thinking ahead here, but more Zealots being warped in here. He's going to have to look at this and kite this, make sure he spends some of that micro. He keeps three at the top going at those drones.
That was actually very well handled by him.
Yeah.
Having that foresight, like you said, with the Roaches in the main base, I wonder if he saw the Warp Prism. Three Mutalis will be enough to kill that. But very little else. Did I miss? Did he make more Mutas than that?
Yeah,
I miss? I think he did.
He lost like all of his gas, so he's got to have some Mutas. Yeah. Production tab just wasn't up. Right now, the double Colossi production, as well as range coming up for Trap, he's getting the plus three to attack as well.
Yeah. The fourth base, it looks like he's going to take to the south, but he can't send his units over there right now because it exposes his third base. And oh my god, these force fields are just disgusting. He's going to just rip that half of the Zerg army apart. But
yeah.
Cassius trying to fight his way through here. He's targeting down sentries smartly.
He's got a lot of roaches here, actually. He's going to push through for now. More force fields go down. Trap is forced to micro this back. And with the Mutas coming around, could maybe do some damage, but no, he's going to have to back off.
I think he really wanted these pushes to line up with each other. Kind of synergize a little bit, but it just did not happen that way. Still killing some probes here, picking off a few stalkers, abusing the low stalker count, and he's actually sticking around, I think, a bit too long. Now he's going to get blunked here. Possibly. Does not get blunked.
Blunked?
Yeah, well, the stalker's blinking under those Mutas, man. That's going to get blunked.
When I first heard that, I didn't even know what you were talking about. I'm like, what? What is that? Blunked?
It's not a thing.
Now I know.
It is a thing now, but it's not really a thing.
It got like, blunked so hard.
It's like the blink stalkers, man. It's not really a thing, but it's kind of a thing.
That could make sense. Blink Stalkers.
He does Blink Stalker builds like all the time.
Yeah.
Blink Stalkers, man. Well, look at this. We have additional Stargates being added. He's not messing around when it comes to dealing with these Mutas. Takes them very seriously.
Yeah. Has stopped Colossi production for now. He is actually supply blocked at 150.
This is a disaster with those Zerglings going to the Colossi. And I don't know if there's actually enough anti-air, though.
Colossi is being focused down by the Muta. Regardless, the Zerglings trying to come around here. He is fighting with all of these Mutas, actually, against Blink Stalkers.
Yeah, I don't think he has enough Zerglings on the ground, really, anymore. With those force fields, it was things went poorly. Does lose the Mothership Core as well. He's going to just fight here again underneath the Overcharge. He's very desperate to do damage right now.
You know, he has a lot of Mutas, and he's doing a lot of damage, but he's losing a lot of Mutas at the same time. And with Phoenix is coming out now, he's going to have to make sure he doesn't lose any more. Flies over a cannon. Good probe pulling by Trap.
Yeah, he actually lost a lot of Mutas, but he did a lot of damage at the same time. He is switching his composition up a little bit. He's now starting to get the upgrades for his Zerglings, which didn't have any, by the way, at all during that fight, which is part of the reason why the plus three Protoss units destroyed them so easily. Usually you think almost like Zerglings is a counter to Blink Stalkers, but not in this case. And I mean, he has a lot of mutilus here still, Brendan. I'm not so sure if Creator actually hasn't, or if Trap has enough.
He has a ton of mutilus here, and Zealots warped in. Those don't attack here. He's going to try to fight this with his Venuses, but flies into the mutas, not microing too well. Loses three.
Yep, there's just so many cannons here, and he doesn't have to trade super efficiently while he's on four bases, and he's keeping Trap on three bases with very few probes. You know, that's his attempt here. He's got the probe count down to 61, which is, it's not the end of the world, but he's definitely done some damage.
Yeah, and he's taking this fifth base now. He's transferring drones as well. He's very good from an economic perspective, but, you know, he can keep trading this. He's getting a bunch of corruptors as well to deal with these phoenixes, try to tank for the mutas.
Yeah, I think it's actually time to switch to void ray production for a Trap, because the corruptors are going to fight the phoenixes head to head just fine. And I mean, he could also just try to fight fire with fire and get you know, the Anion pulse crystal upgrade, and then just try to use his stalkers plus the phoenixes to fight the corruptors with the range upgrade. They, if I'm not mistaken, have the exact same range as the corruptors, so it becomes a little bit different. You know, in those fights without it, it's just totally useless against corruptors, and it's got to be more careful with this Phoenix control. I feel like Trap's like playing a little bit nervous or something. He's just he's making a few mistakes that are uncharacteristic.
Yeah, throughout the whole game, there have just been slight, you know, engagements where he could have just played a little better. More units being caught out, and now he only has these seven Phoenixes flying around, whereas Cassia rather has a huge standing air army.
Yeah. Plus one armor finishes for ground. Anion Pulse Crystals and plus one now for air started, as well as the Templar Archives, which is almost finished, which will unlock Archons and High Templar for Storms, which will help deal with that air army as well. And I think the time of Colossus is basically over. You will need a few, though, to deal with those Infestors. This is just a dominant air force that is going to crush any group of Phoenixes it runs into. He doesn't have Void Rays. And he's like, yeah, try to fight my mutas. I dare you. You don't have stalkers here. Now he's got a few over there, but the damage has already been done.
Yeah, he's going to try to blink and try to fight this, but not going so well. Cassie can just fly out of there. He's got that really fast mobile air army.
All those Infestors, too, Brennan, are building up energy right now, and they are looking for something to fungal.
They're looking for something to fungal. They're
looking for something to fungal, man.
Yeah.
And
he's even getting the Locust upgrade here, Locust Life. This is a nice little run by over here, but it's not going to do too much damage besides killing some of these spine crawlers. Very highly upgraded Zealots, though, do a lot of damage.
Yeah, they certainly do. We'll finally clean this up. The upgrade's a little bit awkward for Cassia because he has like one plus one for range, like for roaches, but he has only plus one for his Zerglings too, and now he's getting plus one carapace for his Mutilus, and he's switching into Swarm Host, so he's just like kind of all over the place with his tech right now.
I like it though. He forced like so many Phoenixes here, and he has like a really good composition here to deal with what Trap is throwing at him.
Yeah, the Phoenixes are no longer a problem for him, especially, I mean, as long as he doesn't bungle the fungal.
You never want to bungle the fungal.
You don't want to bungle the fungal, but if he doesn't bungle the fungal, he should be able to crush this army. And where's that first fungal? He's getting out of there. He knows that he does not want those stalkers to be locked down, or he's going to lose the game right there. Phoenixes are almost useless against this composition because one or two fungals will eliminate all of those. The roach is on the ground, a nice buffer here, and he's just going to start fighting straight up. He needs fungals, though. Where are they?
There's the fungal on all of the Phoenixes.
Every single one of them, and now he's going to get the stalkers as well. There's not enough anti-air to deal with the mutilus. That is how you do not bungle the fungal. Stalkers on the ground, though, actually, with a few more warped in Zealots, may push this back. It looks like he will.
Wow. He's actually going to be able to push this back. 18 mutas and 7 roaches on the way, as well as some more Infestors.
Yeah, the 7 roaches are, just going to be kind of around to help out. Just give a little bit of a buffer. The 18 mutas are going to be a bit annoying to deal with, considering he just lost all of his Phoenixes. He only has a few Archons and Stalkers on the ground for anti-air. Okay, some of the Phoenixes did survive as a rogue group, trying to cause trouble over here.
Troublemakers.
Those troublemaking Phoenixes. They're caught between a Spore and a Corruptor place right now. They do manage to escape. But the Zealot run by, on the other hand. Is that a Zealot statue over there? What's he doing? Now he starts the fight. Now what is he doing? Okay.
He keeps not fighting. It was just so funny.
Oh, wow. He saves the hatch.
Saves the hatch. The mutas are able to pop out in time. I have a
theory about that Zealot. I think he kept pressing hold position to make sure the Zealots were attacking the hatch instead of just right-clicking, and the Zealot was like, all right, I'll stand here.
I think he was trying to get by the Spore Crawler, but was actually just bugging out.
Also acceptable theory. We'll never be certain.
You'll accept my theory? Is that okay?
I will accept that we cannot know the truth. That Fungle is on the money.
No Bungles here.
No All Bungles these... on these Fungles, man, and here we go.
Corruptor's a little bit late to the battle. A lot of the Mutas taking a bit of damage, and this ground army for Cassia is going to go totally down. Missed Fungal there. That was Bungle.
Yeah, you know what? He's trying to make a tough decision right now on what to spend his money on.
And it's more air units.
His ground army is just... It's pitiful, usually, in most of these fights, because he's way down on upgrades. Even the shield upgrade is now being researched for... Wow. That happened. It's now being researched for a trap, but I question some of these commitments. You know, he fights without his corruptors and sticks around, and then when the corruptors get there, he just like doesn't have enough to deal with the archons, and he's like, I guess I gotta walk back again. I lost way too much. Trap takes a supply lead, in fact, and still solid on four bases.
Yeah. Trap's upgrades, man. They've been so good, especially on the ground. And like you said, I mean, all those roaches just get annihilated. Even throwing some immortals in the mix, gonna do so much damage to them. They go down, and then it's just the standing air army for Cassia, is forced to fly away, and he's just not doing enough damage, it seems, with these attacks. His economy is still great. He's still hanging on here. I saw him take a huge puff of air in the booth. Probably a little bit nervous. He definitely wants to win this game. He definitely wants to make a name for himself.
Yeah. If he takes this game, which he was ahead in significantly for a long time, then everyone is going to take him a lot more seriously because he beats Trap, right? He's the top Protoss player right now. Ouch on losing some of those mutas. That was pretty expensive. He's now switching into those swarm hosts that he prepared for earlier. Like, he got the increased lifetime upgrade. He got a few more range upgrades for those. I think they have +3 now, the Locust. And now he's finally making the Swarm Host. He's going to be able to help his air army and attack possibly two locations at once. Okay, it looks like he lost his +3 earlier, or he canceled it. I'm not sure exactly what happened there. Regardless, these Mios could do some damage here, possibly.
Yeah, they're actually going to do a lot of damage. The Phoenixes aren't nearby. He could actually focus down some tech structures. Doesn't do it. Trying to go for these pylons first. Going to supply block Trap heavily here.
Yeah, that's just like too many Phoenixes. Even for his corruptors. Phoenixes just do so much damage so quickly. And because they can fire while moving, well, one of very few units to be able to do this. Just so difficult to escape from them. Oh, that second Fungal anticipating the blink. Does not actually connect the way he wants it to. Needs a magic box to these Archons. Meanwhile, Phoenixes get fungled, but they still do their job against the Infestors, and here they come! Coming over here trying to finish off those Mutalists. And with the Colossus support of the back, it doesn't look like these Swarmos are going to pose too big of a problem for Trap right now.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it much. A lot of these Swarmos being picked up as well. Protoss Ground Army forced to move back here, but the Phoenixes, man, there's just too many of them. The Corruptors that come out here just being sniped down as well.
Yeah. This is, this is spiraling out of control really badly for Cassia. He's just losing left and right, so many units. And his bank has been depleted yet again. Not enough ground army here to actually continue the push, but with his air army, he can continue to harass, pick off drones. Like, picking off drones in the face of corruptors, those Phoenixes are brave, man.
Yeah, it's kind of dwindled here, the Phoenix army, but he did so much damage. He's taken out so many air units of Cassia as well, and that's a really good trade. Making now 3 Void Rays at a time. The one thing he needs, though, is he needs extra bases. He's trying to get that base, that fifth base, up the top there, but the Locusts are coming across slowly.
That's like a Jawa would love to find those probes over there and go start selling them on Tatooine, and they're all just sitting over there ready to be destroyed. Like, if one Infestor would love to fungal all those probes, man. But they're just kind of sitting over there idly by on the idle worker tab. And this is not enough Void Rays, and where are you going, Void Rays?
where are they going indeed? Three free Void Rays.
I have to admit, I think this is one of the most sloppy, pearly games we've had all season. Both players are making, like, disastrously bad mistakes.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to watch, actually, sometimes. This is a nice run by here, or a nice warp in, rather, with the warp prism. The
Queen's Transfusion, like, Queen, but you need some guys to help you. The Vipers are like, no, I'll use Consume, and they're like, no. All right, I guess I'll kill Aspire instead. He allowed that run by to actually kill his base, and now the fifth is up for the Protoss. And the Zealots are actually still here.
They just haven't been dealt with at all. There's nothing they can do.
Yeah, this is, I mean, they're just going to stay up there, I guess. I mean, he's not even sending one wave of Locust back. Understandable, because it costs him a lot of damage to do that. Looks like he's going to make, like, six Roaches, possibly even, like, out of the eggs that the Zealots are attacking right now to defend that. Did he cancel those? What happened to them? Now he starts four. Maybe they were killed by something else.
I think they came out of those eggs you were talking about.
Yeah, maybe. It's, like, really actually dark and hard for me to see exactly how far along things are on a production tab. That's why I made a funny mistake earlier about the plus two research for the Roaches and the ZBZ. But anyways, the Zerg army here is trying to contest this Death Ball. He's trying to pick off Colossi. Relatively successful here. But his economy is in shambles, and these Locusts are free, but they're not really accomplishing anything right now.
They're not getting much damage, and all the while, Trap is able to sit back on this base while Cassia, you know, his not-so-good economy here is just trying to hold up, but it's not doing so well. As the Void Rays come in, he has a ton of Colossi as well. He's going to have a really strong standing army here. Cassia's trying to do what he can. He's trying to attack at the natural here with a bunch of Roaches. They're going to get taken out, though, by Blink Stalkers, and you know, he's trying to pull the Colossi one by one with the Vipers as well. He's trying to do his best to pick up this big standing army, but I don't know if he can hold this for so long.
Yeah, I mean, there goes that Void Ray. There it goes. He's able to do a lot of little things, but he needs to do something bigger, right? That Roach run by was a cool idea, but he's lost creep on the right side of his bases. He no longer has that backdoor expansion. His income is pretty low, all things considered. And what really is going to happen? Well, hold that thought. We have a pretty big engagement here. He gets bungled. He's a little bit timid to commit to the engagement. But what needs to happen next, of course, the Trap is also going to need a new base. And the base at the bottom right is possibly going to be a base that ends up being contested as well. I mean, is Cassia going to live that long, though? That's the question. His drones just finished mining that mineral patch out, and they're just sitting over here. They could actually participate in the fight.
Well, a bunch of these Blink Stalkers get surrounded by drones. This is funny. Roach is trying to hold the base, but the drones are just kind of walking around. Stalker's going to be pushed back for now, but there's no mining going on, man. Yeah. He's got maybe one base there at his fifth.
Yeah, that fifth is his only mining base. The same is soon to be said, though, of Trap, who's running very low on gas. They both are. Storm has researched the last of his gas, and he's going to be able to use that in conjunction with feedback to help deal with some of this air army. Again, double feedback goes off, but it's too late for these two Colossi. He actually turns them around a bit too soon. Could have probably saved one or both of those. And it's these expensive trades and expensive pickoffs that keep Cassia in this game despite having such a terrible economy. He's just able to do little things like this and get away with it and keep his expensive gas units alive.
Yeah. Trap has a lot of minerals here. I'd love to see him go for maybe some Zealot runbys over there at that base, keep the economy of Cassia really low.
Yeah, that base over here that he's taken to the right side, the one I was talking about earlier, is his next hope for money. The same to be said of the base just to the left of that, or Trap, is being taken right now. I think we might see a shift soon, where that becomes the focal point of engagement, and rather than this base, as this base becomes less and less important as it becomes mined out. Just so many waves of Locusts make it very difficult for him to actually relocate his army. He keeps only the Void Rays here because it's enough damage to stop the Locusts, and also it's enough damage to kill the Corruptors. If the Corruptors actually try to come in and help out, he'll be able to deal with those too.
Yeah. This is what I was talking about, by the way. These Zealots coming up here, he was able to warp in those with all of those minerals that he has. He has to keep these Void Rays in position. He doesn't want to get too close, like you were saying, with the Corruptors nearby.
You know, I really feel like if he was targeting those locusts, he could actually possibly have killed the hatchery by now.
Look at this. This is...
That's unnatural. What is this unnatural thing that we're seeing, Brendan?
Trap is going to be disappointed.
This is something that only Duran could have made from StarCraft 1 that I guess you didn't play the campaign of. This unnatural
look, like,
hybrid hatchery nexus. What is this? Spoiler alert for StarCraft 1 campaign. There are some hybrids going on. Special mission. Duran. A.K.A. Narut? Question mark Kappa. Alright, here we go. The Corruptors are just kind of hanging out with these locusts. Now he finally starts to target that nexus, and I feel like he could have done this much earlier. If he just targeted those locusts, he could kill the hatch.
Yeah.
May get it anyways. Nope, they're fighting the probes. Hatch will live to fight another day.
Oh, man. That could be a nexus down if he was on top of it.
Yep.
But unfortunately for Trap, he doesn't have his army really in position. It's going to go down eventually. The sooner the better for Cassia. It seems like he wants to trap, that is, keep his army closer to that base that he just made and maybe go over to the base that Cassia just got, try to take control of this part of the map over here.
Now, this space is toast, man.
Yeah, it's going to be burned to a crisp.
It's going down. All you need to do is right-click on it. And
it's
going to
take about 3 seconds.
Yep. There even less, like 2.1 seconds.
Colossi get pulled. The Corruptor's not doing the best job at focusing, but he is able to get one. Blink Stalker's on the chase.
And on the case, simultaneously.
I'm on the case.
Well, I mean, he's killing this base over to the top left, but it's just not as important anymore because he's already mined most of that out. And the Swarmos are not buried, and they're burrowed, and therefore not producing locusts. So here we go. Storms are going to go crazy here in just a second. He's going to have so much firepower.
Nice Funkle goes on to a lot of the units of Trap here, but all of these Storms and Void Rays doing so much damage. Swarmos being misdirected, going towards the army, a ton of them being taken out. And besides the Fungals, I mean, not much damage going down here onto the army of Trap. It looks too big.
Yep. Another Storm goes down here on top of those Corruptors. And, I mean, this is game. Cassia put up a great fight here. This is one of those games where, again, it looks like he's leveled up a little bit further, but it's just not enough. He's not ready yet to play with the big boys. He had some leads in this game. He certainly could have won this game under different circumstances. Especially considering how scrappy of a game it was. But Trap is going to end him here. Probably could have just feedbacked those queens. And the Void Rays can even, without their prismatic alignment, kill these Corruptors with Stalker support.
Yeah. It was just too big of a standing army here for Trap. He eventually went for the big attack. That was it.
GG. Cassia loses, and Trap, along with Incredible Miracle, will take the win today. Very impressive play by Cassia. He tangoed with Trap, one of the best Protoss players in the world.
It takes two to tango.
It does.
And
as Doa once said, it takes plus two to tango, but he delayed his plus two in his timing attack and still won the game.
Well, there were times where Cassia was ahead, and I just feel like, you know, some of the engagements after that happened just weren't the best idea, and he lost a lot of his army. He wasn't trading as efficiently as he was earlier on. And from there, it kind of settled down. He looks really defeated.
I think he knows that he had the game nearly won at times, made just some control mistakes and with his Mutalis and his Corruptors, took some engagements that he shouldn't have, and lost his bank just a few too many times as a result. Whereas if he had fought some of those fights, especially that one fight at the third base where he fought with the Mutalis,